extract some 3.1 meter logs in an hour 560.4 forwarder. We're in a stick of spruce thinning here. In Scotland, just backing up the rack to these logs. It's a 5.5 ton forwarder, built in southern Sweden. Two-meter Cranab crane on it, so it's a nice, fast, flexible crane. Double extension and a Grippen grapple on the end. Really nice, smooth and easy to operate crane. I go for the double extension on it just because it makes that telescope a little bit faster, so speeds up operation in the woods. There's also an option for a single extension, which has slightly more total lift capacity on it, but you don't have the reach and it's not quite as fast. The mini lever controls from Parker IQAN. A really nice, smooth, sensitive control of the crane. Another nice thing, automatic center brake, so you can be using the crane as you drive along, and then as soon as you stop, the brake engages and stabilizes the forwarder. Controls at your fingers, so you can be steering with this dial while you're driving and while you're moving the crane, allowing you to do everything in smooth, continuous motion. Anyone who knows the Malwa well might have noticed the view is slightly different. In this machine we've got an extended height headboard as well as extension pins. These are fitted as standard from the factory for the UK. The reason being we deal with a lot of 3 metre timber in the UK rather than the longer product lengths that they deal with in Scandinavia. So in order to better get the weight on, we get a standard higher headboard. New machines have the seat rotation on a button on the pads here rather than the old style kick plate for rotating the seat. Just little improvements make the newer machines a little easier to use. You get a little bit more space for your feet when turning around. I love how nimble these little forwarders are. We do a lot of thinning and shelter belts and in smaller woods, which is surrounded by fences. And you don't want to be just having straight racks coming out the end and coming out of the fences. So we've got to weave through the wood to get to a gate. And if we open the wood up too much, it becomes more susceptible to wind blow. So small Malwa machines weave their way through with reasonably small canopy openings and allow you to get in and out of a single extraction point. The other thing is the 10-foot gate, and we sneak out no problem. Those bigger machines, you'd have a problem. Another nice feature, you've got continuous speed adjust on this left-hand dial. So in the woods you can wind it down and you're not trying to balance the throttle on your foot over bumps. As we wind that up, speed goes up a little bit. And that is continuous from stopped right the way up through the gears range. You got four gears controlled on these buttons here. Two working gears and then two road gears. The road gears only work when the machine's pointing forwards, and they disengage the rear wheel drive as well, so you just switch into two wheel drive. And those road gears will take you up to 20 kilometers an hour, which apparently is the maximum you're allowed in the EU when controlling by just a joystick. You can see here, when I'm not in crane mode, all the steering is done with this right hand joystick. Air conditioning module there, keeping it nice and comfortable in the cab. And these are just lights for headlights, switches for headlights. There's the additional trailer, which we're not using at the moment, but it ups the carrying capacity to about 9 tons. Going off just because I've allowed the fuel to get a bit low. So I think it's warning me my fuel's down to 10 litres into the reserve. And nice and new machine, you can spin the seat, have it facing, switch on the crane with that button, and then we're off again. People comment when they see pictures with a big crane and the length of extension that it looks too long for the machine and that it's not going to handle anything. yeah, you can't lift a huge amount of weight at full reach, and you've got to be a little bit careful of the stability of the machine. But you're often not trying to lift big logs way out. It's about getting your grab fulls on and off the machine as quickly as possible, and it handles that very well. You can see I'm not having to limit my grab fulls. And even with a bunk empty, it's still lifting that grab full a long way out, not giving the machine too many problems. The crane nestles nicely into the bunk. It's got a small cradle to sit in. Grapple sits there, giving a real solid crane position. Got things like window wipers, everything at your fingertips, lights on, forward reverse, diff locks, front and rear. It's full mechanical hydrostatic drive, so you've got a really, really good drive system. And with the hydrostatic, you just press accelerator and go. Anyway, I think that's about it just now. I hope you enjoyed that, and join me again soon. I'll do a bit of a walk around showing some of the features of the machine. Okay, thanks. Bye.